morning, students. So, in the previous class, we come to know about the sex determination, right? Sex determination in the different organisms we come to know. Okay. So, like we have seen the sex determination type, like a heterogamety in a males, heterogamety in a females. In the male, in the males, different type of a gametes. If we have that, that's what we call that as a heterogamety. If we have the different type of gametes in a female, we call it as a heterogamety in a females. Okay, there we have seen like a the examples like a birds, drosophila, butterfly, and some of the other examples we have seen. Today we will concentrate on the sex determination in the humans. Sex determination in human. Okay, sex determination in human. So basically, in the case of a human, it is a heterogamety we are going to see. Like the female has a the homogametes. The when it comes to the male, it has a heterogametes. Like some the sperm may contain X chromosome and some other sperm contain a Y chromosome. Okay. So here we are going to see. So the sex determination mainly depend upon which type of a sperm has been entered inside the ova. Like we have seen on that day, if there is an egg in the male, the sum of the gamete of a male gamete which contain a X chromosome and other gamete contain a Y chromosome, right? So here what will happen, which sperm has been entered inside the ova, okay? If the sperm with the X chromosome will enter inside the ova, that the progeny will be the female or the girl, okay? If the sperm with the Y chromosome, then the resulting offspring will be the male, okay? Or the boy, okay? So this is what we have seen, okay? And the same type of a sex determination we have seen in the drosophila. In the case of a drosophila also, we have seen the heterogamety in a males. Same in the case of human beings also, here we are going to see heterogamety in a males, right? So we will go through the chromosomes, chromosomal level. We will concentrate on the chromosomal level here. So parent one generation, in the case of a parent one generation, here the male contain 44 autosomes plus the chromosome like the X and the Y. X and the Y, they are two dissimilar gametes or the chromosomes what we are going to see. So same in the case of a female, the 44 autosomes and the homogametes we are going to see, like the XX chromosome we are going to see, right? So you can concentrate here, 44 autosomes, along with that there are two gametes we are going to see. So totally in the case of a human beings, the 46 chromosomes we are able to see, 46 chromosomes. Otherwise, if we consider that in a pair, that will be the 23 pairs of chromosomes, right? So you can see here the 44 and the 2 and the 44 and the 2. So A means the autosomes, like a body cells, whatever we call that as a body cells, right? So those are the autosomes and the remaining two will be the allosomes. Otherwise we also call them as a sex chromosomes. We call them as a sex chromosomes. Now the gametes here we are going to see. Gametes here we are going to see. It will undergo with the meiotic process. There is the formation of a right. Okay. So it will show that the offspring will be the male. Offspring will be the male, right? So 44 autosomes, XY is the male. So here 44A, XX, that will be the female. This is how the identification of the sex of the baby. Such determination is nothing but the identification of the sex of the baby. In the progeny, which sex is going to be formed, like a male or the female, or that is the boy or the girl formation will take place. So, in the case of a male, we are going to see the 44 autosomes along with the two chromosomes like a X and a Y. In the case of a female, 44 autosomes along with the two chromosomes, homogametes like a XX, right? So, when it undergoes with the meiotic process, the half of the gamete will contain a the 22 autosomes along with that a X chromosome, and the remaining half of the gametes which contain a 22 autosomes along with that a Y chromosome. In the case of a male, same in the case of a female, what will happen? The half of the gamete will contain a 22 autosomes and the X chromosome. The remaining will be also the 22 autosomes and the X chromosome we are going to see. When in the case of a progeny, progeny is nothing but a offspring. Okay, the whatever the baby is going to be for. If the gamete with the 22 autosomes with the X chromosome is fused with the another, in the case of female, 22 autosomes with the X chromosome, the coming generation will be the coming progeny will be the female, because you can see here 44 autosomes and the XX chromosome, right? If the another gamete with the Y chromosome, if it has been fused with the ova of the female, so then the 44 autosomes, the gametes here we are going to see like a XY, that is a XY, we call it as a male baby formation is taking place. So it completely depends, the sex determination, the human beings is completely depend upon the male. Okay, the male is going to be decide the sex of the baby, like whether the baby is a male or the female, because the male is a basically the heterogamety in the case of a human beings. Okay, so this is how we are going to see the sex determination of the human beings. So now we will concentrate on the sex determination in honeybee. That is nothing but a the gamete is a the haploid. Okay. Sorry, diploid. Then in the case of a male, it is a 16. That means it is a haploid. It is a haploid. That n number, total number, that is a diploid, and the n number, that is a haploid. Right. So gametes here we are going to see, it will undergo in the meiotic process. So 32 chromosomes have been seen, we have seen in the first case, but here we are going to see after the meiotic process it will be divided, and thus in some gametes we are going to see the 16 chromosomes, in the other gamete we are going to see the 16 chromosomes. So in the case of a female, it has been undergone with the meiotic process. Here it will undergo with the mitotic process. Same here, the 16 chromosomes formation will take place. Right. So next, what will happen in the case of the male, in the female? So if the egg got unfertilized, that will be developed into a, so you can see 16, right? So that is basically the male. There is no fusion of gametes has been taken place. So that's why it will develop into a male. So here it has been fused with the one of the gamete has been fused with the male gamete. So and basically when it has been fused, the fertilization process will be taking place. Fertilization process will take place. So when it has got fertilized, we are going to see total number of chromosomes, like a 2n and the 32. So the progeny will be the female. So female has a 32 chromosomes, the male has a 16 chromosomes. So the sex determination is in the honeybee is quite different from the other organisms. Like if the egg got fertilized, that will become a female. If the egg doesn't fertilize, otherwise unfertilized, that will become a male. So it will undergo with the meiotic process. The gametes will get separate, and the some of the gametes will get the 16 chromosomes, and some other gametes will get the other 16 chromosomes. Okay, when it comes to the male, it will undergo with the mitotic process. We are going to get the same, the 16 chromosomes we are going to get. Then if the whatever the gamete formed in the female, if it is unfertilized, it will become a male. It has been developed into a male. If the egg got gamete got fertilized with the male gamete, and the further process will be fertilization. After the fertilization, we are going to see again the 32 chromosomes that will become a, that will develop into a, the female. So this is how the sex determination will take place in the honeybee. Okay, these two concepts, like a sex determination in the human beings and the sex determination in the honeybee. Thank you.